Is it a good argument? That's really the foundational question of this course and textbook. To assess the strength of arguments, we have to look at two different things: an argument's form and its content. Now remember that at the most general level, arguments can be distinguished into those that are deductive and those that are inductive. You've undoubtedly encountered these terms in other contexts, and I wouldn't be surprised if you've encountered the following definitions. It's often said that inductive arguments go from specific to general, while deductive arguments go from general to specific. These definitions trace back to the 19th century philosopher of science, William Whewell. However, they're not very good definitions. Especially with advances in 20th century logic, they're really not applicable anymore. So the way that we're going to distinguish these concepts is in terms of the degree of strength that is claimed to hold between the argument's premises and the conclusion. In particular, we're going to say, inductive arguments are arguments in which the arguer is attempting to provide strong but non-conclusive evidence for a particular claim. A deductive argument, on the other hand, is going to be an argument in which the arguer is attempting to provide conclusive evidence for a claim. Deductive logic is often called formal logic. This suggests correctly that the form of an argument is of paramount importance. The premises of a deductive argument are constructed in such a way that the arguer intends the conclusion to follow necessarily. If this sounds like mathematical reasoning, it's because they are related. Consider the following very basic argument form. A is equal to B, B is equal to C, so A is equal to C. It doesn't matter what A, B, and C represent. So long as those premises are true, the conclusion, A is equal to C, follows necessarily from them. Now, the more that you study logic, the more you'll become familiar with deductive forms and learn to recognize them. Inductive logic is often called informal logic. This suggests, correctly, that it's really the content of inductive arguments that is of most importance. There are some kinds of inductive arguments, like analogical arguments, that have a common form, but this isn't generally true of them. Instead, we need to use our judgment to decide whether the content provided in the premises of the arguments is sufficient to establish their conclusions. Scientific reasoning is very much like this. In scientific reasoning, a researcher will form a hypothesis to try to explain some phenomenon, and then they'll go out and search for evidence to either confirm or disconfirm the hypothesis. If the researcher is not able to disconfirm the hypothesis, then that's taken as evidence that we should accept it. However, it's generally understood that there could always be evidence out there that could disprove what it is that we believe to be true. Okay, so let's conclude then by looking at the concepts covered in this section. Recall that we began with the notion of an argument. An argument is a set of propositions, one of which, the conclusion, is claimed to follow from the others, the premises. At the most general level, arguments are distinguished into those that are deductive and those that are inductive. Deductive arguments are either valid or invalid. A valid deductive argument is one in which the conclusion follows necessarily from the premises. If a valid argument is also sound, that means that it has all true premises. If it's valid and sound, then of course that means that the conclusion is also true. An unsound valid argument is one in which at least one premise is false. Inductive arguments, we say, are either strong or weak. A strong inductive argument is one in which the evidence presented in the premises provides sufficient reason for us to believe the conclusion. A cogent strong argument, then, is a strong argument which has all true premises. A non-cogent strong argument has at least one false premise. The rest of the semester and the rest of this text will concern how to apply these various concepts.